Determining the time of the end. False prophets. The intention to determine the time of the approaching world judgment does not correspond to my will and my wisdom, which recognizes full well that knowing the time and hour would not be beneficial to you humans, as it would influence your thoughts as well as your actions, and therefore it will be kept a secret by me, in spite of my constant announcements, warnings and reprimands. You humans have to conduct your life in free will. Constant references to the approaching end are certainly good, but not the exact knowledge of time and hour. Indeed, the end, the world judgment, is very close at hand, and I will repeatedly mention it to you. Nevertheless, you all will be taken by surprise, because no one will expect it with certainty and believe in the approaching end. But anyone who believes that he can specify the time and hour is not my messenger, and his words should not be trusted, even though he claims to speak on my behalf, even though he wants to guide his fellow human beings to the right faith in me. All the same, this claim cannot have been imparted to him by my spirit, it cannot have originated from me, it is his own product of thought which he firmly believes to be truth, and therefore he tries to spread it. No one knows the day and hour. Remember these words, which I spoke to my disciples on earth. As God and creator of infinity, I am well aware of this day and hour since eternity, yet my wisdom prevents me from proclaiming this knowledge to you humans. For it concerns the human being's will, which may not be infringed, but it would be infringed by any precise revelation of the last day. The day itself has indeed been predetermined since eternity, but so are all events preceding it which aim to contribute towards the voluntary change of the human being's will. And thus I will do everything which helps and enables the human being to expect my judgment on the last day in the right frame of mind. But if a person himself makes no use of it, his fate is already decided for an infinitely long time. To know the day and hour of the end would then result in a compulsory change of his nature, which, however, would neither entitle him to enter the kingdom of light nor the paradise of the new earth, but it would not result in eternal perdition either. Because anguish and fear determine his will and not love, which should be the only reason for a change of will. Thus his love would not be sufficient, and therefore one cannot speak of a change of disposition. Nevertheless, the human being has to be given credit for his will to do right. He effectively would be obedient, not due to love but due to fear. Yet love is the crucial factor in the end. For I want to separate the sheep from the goats. I want to initiate a purification process and thereby end one period of redemption before the beginning of a new one. Hence a clear decision of will has to take place, for which people have ample time and opportunity, and in order to motivate them they are informed of the end. But they have to make their choice entirely without compulsion. Therefore I will keep the day and hour a secret, but it will come like a thief in the night. It will arrive when no one is expecting it, when people find their satisfaction in the enjoyment of life, when they chase one enjoyment after another, when they forget everything around themselves and are merry, when they experience utmost joy of life. Then the day will dawn which brings everything to an end. And then it will emerge who will stand by me or by my adversary, who is lord of this world. Everything will then be revealed, light and darkness, truth and lie, love and hatred. No one will be able to hide himself or conceal his true nature. Then everyone will show his true face, because the hardship around him pulls the mask off his face, and then everyone will receive his fair reward. Light or darkness, heavenly bliss or eternal damnation. Amen.